Hi, this is Tom from Line 6 Australia, and this is part 4 of our Podgo tutorial videos. In this video, we'll be exploring Podgo Edit. Podgo Edit is a program that enables you to store and record presets or edit your patches and is available on Mac or PC. So here we have the Podgo Edit, and this is the patch we created earlier. Now, I can actually just turn effects on and off directly from Podgo Edit, and you can see how that responds on the Podgo. And instead of using the action button to move effects around, I can actually just click and drag and move them from wherever I want to within my chain. And for changing footswitch assignments, we can see the footswitch assignments above each pedal here. If I want to change, say, this one to, I'll turn the effect on so you can see this. I'm now going to change this simply to number 1, and it moves from here to here. So that's a much quicker way of changing where you want to assign your foot switches. So now over on the left-hand side of the screen here, I've got my list of presets. I can now just right-click here and now just rename my preset. And then I can save here by pressing Control S. And now this overwrites here on the screen and on my Podgo here. So again, this is a faster way of renaming your presets. Now, another great feature of the Podgo is I can actually now simply export my preset. So I can save that onto my PC or Mac. And so I can save more than, say, the 256 presets that the Podgo can store. And by the same way, I can import any presets that I wish to into my library here. And if you head over to Custom Tone, where there's a large library of sounds, you can simply import those sounds into your Podgo via Podgo Edit. So over on the top left-hand side, we have different menus. On the File menu, I can save or export presets. I can import the whole set list, so that's the whole set list of 128 presets. I can create a backup of my Podgo, which is a complete backup of every preset, impulse response, and every global setting that I have stored. And again, conversely, I can restore from a backup I've created. So that was part 4 of our Podgo video tutorials. Thanks for watching.